हेलो फ्रेंड्स, गुड मॉर्निंग। आई होप यू ऑल हैव कंप्लीटेड माय पास्ट लेक्चर रिलेटेड ऑल टॉपिक्स। नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अवर न्यू टॉपिक। इट इज रिलेटेड टू मॉनेटरी पॉलिसी। व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय द मॉनेटरी पॉलिसी? दिस वन वी हैव कंप्लीटेड इन माय लास्ट लेक्चर। मॉनेटरी पॉलिसी इट इज जस्ट लाइक अ टूल, यू कैन से, और यू कैन से इट इज कॉन्स्टिट्यूट्स द कॉन्शियस स्टेप्स which undertaken by the monetary authority. Now in our India, monetary authority is RBI. So this type of step only and only take by the RBI, correct? Which brings about changes in the stock of money, source, then generation of money and cost of money. Second, I said that the policy which entrust various tools of the regulating supply of money in the hand of the apex bank. In India, apex bank is RBI, okay, with the purpose of achieving general economic objective. It is called monetary policy. It's most IMP question for 2 marks. What do you mean by the monetary policy? And another one question for 3 marks from this chapter. Okay, it's most IMP question for this. So without any fail, you have to learn each and every instrument of the monetary policy. If there's all instrument will in detail, then it will be in 3 marks. Otherwise, it will only for 2 marks also it will be select. So please carefully, you have to learn all points from this topic. Okay. If you want, you can write from this chapter 1, its total weightage. This chapter's total weightage is 8 marks. Okay. And from this chapter, one will be, chapter number 4 has, one will select, from this chapter will select one MCQ, 2 1-mark question, 1 2-mark question, and 1 3-mark question. So this question is most IMP for your 3-mark question. Okay, students? So without any fail, you have to learn. If this question will select for 3 marks, then it's okay. You can write this all quantitative and qualitative measures. If this question will not select for 3 marks, any one point, any one type of the quantitative or qualitative measure will select for 1 or maybe for 2 marks. But it's most IMP. From this, it is 100% sure from this chapter, any one question will be select. Okay, so you have to learn without any fail this topic properly. Okay, so now we are discussing this instrument. In this, we will discuss about 2 types. Whenever you are going to write for 3 marks, you have to write in this way. This way is, first of all, we have to write heading. Okay, students? First of all, we have to write heading. Like this, we have to write this heading. First of all, quantitative tools of the monetary policy. Tools of monetary policy. Then after, we have to write quantitative, this one, and qualitative. Quantitative measures, you can write quantitative tools, and second one is qualitative or selective tools, correct? And then after we have to write it sub point. First of all, we have to write main heading. What is the main heading? Main heading is tools of monetary policy, okay? And by that, you have, after that, you have to write quantitative and qualitative. In the quantitative and qualitative, you have to write this both. Then you have to write their sub points. Their sub points are, from this I'm going to explain. So there's all sub points you have to write. Quantitative measures are, first one, quantitative measure, that means what? Which aimed at impact inter-economics, general common way, and hence these are also called general measures. What type of measures are called general measures? Because of in Marvel, if you will make these questions, you will get it. A question has last 2 years back, what do you mean by the general measures? General measures, that means what? The quantitative measures are aimed it impacts the entire economy in the general or common way, and hence these are also called general measures. It is answer for the general measures and for the quantitative tools of the monetary policy. Okay, now second one is qualitative tools. Qualitative tools will directly affect to the, not to the quantity, but indirectly they will affect to the economy, and they will mostly focus on the quality. Okay, these are qualitative tools. After this we will discuss that also. Now first one point is bank rate. What do you mean by bank rate? Like this question also, in past 2 years one question has general measures and last to last year question has in Marvel. If you will make, you can make this question. What do you mean by the bank rate? What do you mean by the bank rate? Bank rate, that means what? For 2 months this type of question will be, next year also maybe. So please, you have to learn this all type of quantitative measures in detail, not only main headings, not only their meaning in two line one sentence. You have to learn proper, you have to understand, so you can learn easily. That not very difficult, it's very easy if you will create some images in your mind. Okay, so first one is the bank rate. What is the quantitative tool for the monetary policy? First one, quantitative or general measure is bank rate. Bank rate, that means what? In the long term, actually this one has not now at present, it has before some time period which has used by the RBI. At present this has not used by the RBI, but we have to learn its meaning. What is the bank rate? Bank rate, that means whenever this commercial banks have require of any type of money, they can borrow from the RBI in long term. You remember this word, long term. Okay, whenever commercial bank have requirement of money, they can borrow from the RBI for the long term, and it is called bank rate. Correct? One sentence answer for 1 mark, this much. The whenever commercial bank have shortage of the fund, they borrow from the RBI, and whatever bank rate, whatever rate will decide by the RBI for that fund, that is known as bank rate. Look at here, commercial bank have, whenever commercial bank have shortage of fund, they borrow from the RBI. The rate at which RBI lend to the commercial banks, for which time period? For long term. It's known as bank rate. Okay, but it, you remember this thing, it is for the long term. Clear? It, if the bank rate is increased, now we have completed what is the main means of the bank rate in the first sentence. Now in the second sentence we are discussing it, how it will be affect to the economy. Correct? If bank rate is high, for an example, bank rate is 10%. Okay, when it will be increased 10 to 15%. Okay, 10 to 15%, that means what? Bank rate increase, then commercial bank will borrow less money. Why? Because of borrowing will be expensive, so commercial bank will borrow less money. If they will borrow less money, obviously they will lend to their customer less, then credit creation will be less, that means in the market money supply will be less. Clear? In what time period that this type of rate will be decided by, should be decided by the RBI? During the inflation. During the inflation, RBI have to decide this type of bank rate, high bank rate, to control the inflation. Okay, second side we are explaining, or we will discuss, whenever in the market already money shortage is there, so RBI will decide the policy, and in that policy RBI will decide the low bank rate. If bank rate will low, whenever bank rate will low, that means what? Supply of money will be high. supply of money will be high. And whenever supply of money will be high, that means people can be easily borrow, because of by the less rate, bank rate will decide by the RBI. So commercial will borrow more money. When commercial banks will borrow more money, they can lend money to their customer by the less rate, interest rate. Okay, and less interest rate is there, so people can easily borrow money from the commercial bank, and money supply will be increased. Correct. So this, it is just like instrument, tools to control the economy, to control the economic situation and create a normal price level. This type of instrument will use by the RBI. Okay. Next one is, it is given some years related bank rate. In 1953, bank rate has 3.5%. In 1981, it has 10%. 1991, it has 12%. But in 2016, it has only 7%. Okay. It is correct data because of source also given, www.rbi.org. If you want, you can also collect information regarding this by internet. Okay. So this stopped using this bank rate as an instrument to regulate the money supply since last few years. But it has stopped by the RBI. Okay. And it present repo rate and reverse repo rate is instead of this bank rate. Okay. So because of it is only for long term, not for the short term. And mostly problems are related to short term period. So RBI have decided bank rate, repo rate and reverse repo rate on the place of the bank rate. Correct. Now next one topic we are going to discuss. Next one topic is the repo rate and reverse repo rate. Very, very IMP question. Okay. It's most IMP. You can say it's very, very IMP. Okay. In this you have to write it. You have to learn it perfectly because of last year it has, but again it will be repeat. 99% chances for this, it will repeat again. This or reverse repo rate. Maybe in difference or maybe in characteristic or maybe in meaning. But it is 99% chances this question also will be repeat. Okay. Maybe in MCQ, but it will repeat. What do we mean by the repo rate? First we will discuss this one. Then we will discuss reverse repo rate. Students, tell me if you have need of money, what will you do? You will say, ma'am, we will borrow from our father, mother. Yeah, obviously you can borrow from the mother and father, but if your father and mother have requirement of money, what they will do? Ma'am, they will borrow from their friends, relatives and bank. Correct. They can borrow money from their friends, relatives and bank. But you know, students, that friends and relatives will not provide this much money to them. In the case of that, they can borrow money from the bank. Correct? So this bank from which they can, this commercial bank can borrow. This commercial bank can borrow money from the RBI. Okay? And now I said mostly problems are related to short. Correct? So if they have requirement money or a fund for very short term period, for what time period? For very short time period, maybe 1 day, 7 days or 15 days. Okay. So they can sell who? Commercial bank. They can sell some securities. What do you mean by securities? Now you know very well because of you are not economics students, you are OC student also. So you know what do you mean by the securities. So banks will sell some securities which are held by them to RBI. To whom they will sell? To RBI they will sell some securities. It's most IMP word. You remember this word. There's commercial banks sell some securities which are held by them to RBI with a repurchase agreement. For what? For with a repurchase agreement at particular rate, and this rate is known as repo rate. Okay. For example, I have a bank. Okay, it is scheduled bank, and so many customers want to borrow money from me, but I have not much money for this. So what I will do? I will borrow money from the commercial bank or from the RBI. First, I will try to borrow from the commercial bank, but commercial bank also have very scarce money. So what I have to do? As a commercial bank, I have to borrow money from the RBI, because of RBI is, we have completed in the functions. RBI is the last source for the this type of lend money. So I will borrow, my bank will borrow money from the RBI, but it should be for the short term period, 1 day, 7 days or 15 days. For that, I will sell some securities to RBI with a repurchase agreement at a particular rate. And this repurchase agreement on this whatever particular rate has decided, it is called repo rate. Maybe 5%, 6%, 6.25%, like that. Okay. So banks sell government securities to RBI. What bank will sell? Bank will sell some government securities to RBI in order to raise money for a few short term, with a condition to repurchase at some discount. Such a discounting rate is repurchase rate, or you can say repo rate. Okay. Now next one, in the event of the inflation, suppose inflation is there. In market, inflation is there. During that time, what type of condition or what type of rate should be decided by the RBI? You got very well what is the inflation time period. So you can say this answer. Listen carefully again this question and think one time. If in market inflation is there, correct? During inflation, what type of decision should be taken by the central bank? This repo rate should be increased or decreased? During inflation, already money supply is more. So during inflation, what type of monetary policy decided by the RBI, by the central bank during inflation? This type of bank rate should be increased or decreased by the central bank? When inflation is there, that means already money supply is more in the market. Then increase repo rate. When repo rate will increase, this commercial will borrow less money. Okay. And whenever commercial will borrow less money, that means in market, they will lend less money. If they will lend less money, that means people will borrow less. And thus, money supply and inflation are arrested. Correct? Opposite condition. In the deflation time period, what type of decision should be taken by the RBI or central bank during deflation? During deflation, money quantity of money, that means supply of money, is already less. So what should be do by the central bank? What type of decision should be taken by the central bank? Central bank should be increase or decrease during inflation. Central bank will increase or decrease the repo rate. We said that in the inflation, repo rate will be increased. During deflation, repo rate should be decreased, because of government want to supply more money in the market. Due to that reason, during the deflation time period, repo rate should be decreased by the RBI, and in that case, In market, there's people who want to borrow money, they will borrow more. And thus in the market, money supply will be increased. And this deflation critical condition will be controlled from the market by this quantitative tool. Correct? Next one. Actually, in this both are given in the same answer. But I had explained first the repo rate. Now I'm going to explain reverse repo rate. Reverse. By name you can get, I think. Reverse repo rate. Reverse repo rate, that means what? In this, RBI will repurchase its securities from the commercial bank. Look at here. Repo rate, that means commercial bank will sell their securities to the RBI and they will get money, they can borrow money. Here condition is opposite. In the reverse repo rate, these peoples from the peoples are or from the bank, RBI will repurchase its securities from the commercial bank in the event when the RBI has a borrow short-term fund from the commercial bank by parking its securities with the commercial bank. It's known as reverse repo rate. Correct? Even the RBI sells government securities held by it to commercial banks under the condition of repurchasing those at a discounted rate upon the end of the short-term period. Okay. Now next one is an increase in reverse repo rate means that commercial bank will get more incentives to park. Okay. Their fund will with the RBI by lending more to RBI. Okay. Thereby decreasing their lending to general public and ultimately reducing the supply of money in the market and vice versa. So it is related to three points. These are related to what was the condition of the repo rate and reverse repo rate in 2006, 10 and 2016. In January 2006, repo rate has 6.65. Reverse repo rate has 5.50. Correct? And in the March 2010, repo rate has 5.0, reverse repo rate has 3.50. In the April 2016, repo rate has 6.5, reverse repo rate has 6%. You can say mostly repo rate is higher than reverse repo rate. Okay. Next one is stabilization under emergency situation. Stabilization. Stabilization, that means immediately any type of emergency is there. Immediately any commercial bank has required to borrow money. In that case, who will help to them? Who will help them? There's all other commercial bank also have not much money for that. All other branches or other banks, commercial bank also have not much money. In that case, in the last RBI can be lend the money to the commercial bank immediately. Okay. And in the very short term, you can say less than one day. Okay. So this type of there is a special window for banks. What type of banks? Commercial banks to borrow from the RBI against approved government security in the emergency situation, like an acute case shortage. This rate is higher than repo rate, and in 2016 this rate has 7% and repo rate and reverse repo rate has less. Repo rate has 6.5%. What is the MSF? What is the marginal standing facility? It has only 7%. Okay. Now next one is cash reserve ratio. cash reserve ratio, that means what? We'll discuss this topic next week, not now. Cash reserve ratio. Cash reserve ratio also very interesting point, but we will discuss next day. I hope you all have understood. If you have any query, any type of doubt, you have to message me. Okay? I will solve your doubts. And please, students, you have to start your hard study. In the absence of that, you cannot get good marks. Correct? So start your study very well and complete your syllabus at the time, because of you have a requirement of the much time for the revision. In the absence of revision, you cannot write correct and excellent answer. So now you have requirement for the excellent answers. You have to write answers in your notebook. If you will not write proper in the proper time, maybe you know that answer because of the less time period, you will enable to explain this all. Okay. Last year, Tulsi has in my class in 12th B, I think, 12th B, yeah. That time, in the last final exam, she know very well this all answers. She know very well this all. But in the, because of the time schedule management, because of the time schedule management, she cannot, she will not written this all answers. Okay. She had not written this all answer. She left 20 marks, so yeah, 25-20 marks questions. Okay. Yeah, she got 70 marks, but 25 answers marks answer she has not written. What about it? If she has written this all answer, maybe she can get 95 or 90. But due to slow writing, she has not written. She has not perfect time management. And she has not written all answers. So I'm saying to all, please, you have to start your writing practice. And economics, we have requirement of this all content. If we will write content full answer, then only we can get full out of full marks. Otherwise, it's very critical problem. You cannot get full out of full marks in the sense of good and excellent writing and presentation. So have, you have to write in a good handwriting, in an excellent presentation. And you have to manage your time limit. Okay, students, thank you. Bye.